Hello to all the authors and creator out there. So, if you had created a manuscript on Google Docs and uploaded it to Kindle Create, and if you have edited in Kindle Create and then realized that you can no longer bring it back to a Word doc to make more changes to it, you're in luck. You actually can. Every so-called expert out there is telling us that it's not possible to convert it back to a Word doc. But thank God I found through a lot of research this guy by the name Stem Stephens, and I really thank him for putting together a list of steps of how to convert your KPF file back into a DOCX file with the latest changes you have made in your Kindle Create software. So here is how, step by step. I will also post those steps below the video so you can follow his steps. But I wanted to make a video as there are no videos about it and there are no instructions on YouTube about it that I could find. And I was pretty frustrated yesterday when I realized that I really needed to convert my KPA file in into a Word docs in order to do final editing properly. So let's start. Your first step is to download this software from this website called Calibre. And you simply get to this website, calibre-ebooks.com. You'll see in the instructions, and you'll download this software. Once you download the software, this is it. You'll have it on your computer, and I've already opened it, and this is how it looks. So the next step, once you have the software, is really simple. You're going to open the software, click on Preferences, go to the plugin page, go to Get New Plugin, and here you want to search for a plugin called KFX. That is KFX. And there you go. You will find two KFX plugins. One will be the output and the other one will be the input. The one you want is the input, okay? So highlight the KFX input plugin and click install, then close the window. I already did it, so you cannot see it here, but just click on install of the input plugin. And then close this window, close all the other windows, and I recommend, and he recommends, that you reboot the Calibre software. Next step, you go back into preferences, you go back into the plugin, and this time stay on this page and look for a plugin called KPF Extract. So we're looking for KPF Extract. And there you go. You'll have to click the next button because it's on the next button, next page. And when you get to it, it will be highlighted and the icon will be green. As you see, I already took the action, so it's not green anymore. But if it is green on your end, you will click on Enable Disable Plugin button. Okay, once you click on it, it will disable this plugin, the KPF Extract, and you will no longer have the icon green. As you see, it is a bit grayish here. That's it. And then click OK, close it, close all the windows, and reboot again just to be on the safe side. Next step, you will find your KPF file, your book, on your desktop or wherever it is in your computer. Find it and drag it into this area. This is basically your library of books, okay, on this Calibre software. So drag your book into this area, let it upload, and then simply highlight it. Like I did here, this is my book, highlight it and click convert. Okay. You'll get to this page. And as you see, the input already is recognized and it is a KPF file, and you will need to choose your desired output. So for, in that case, we're going to be converting it to a DOCX file, and that's basically it. Click OK, and voila, it's converting. I've already done it yesterday. I'm doing it again just to show you. And now that we're back on this page, you're going to go into, again, select, make sure this your book is highlighted. And then you're going to click on the right-hand side. You see path, click to open. Now you're going to click on that and voila, you have your book, as you see, with the latest editing that you have made in Kindle Create, now in a Word Docs format. Okay, so when you open it, you'll have your entire book as it was in Kindle Create in a Word Docs format. You can do all your editing, whatever it is you need to do, and make changes, and then upload it to Kindle Create again or to any other software you wish. Well, good luck. Happy creations, and I'll see you in the next video, whatever it may be. Hope that helps. And again, thank you, Sam Stephens, for putting out those instructions. It literally saved my day yesterday.